Welcome back to Healthy and Delicious. We are going to be starting our first recipe of the day. So tell us, Chef Lena, what are we going to make?
Finally, we're going to cook something in cooking show.
Woo-hoo.
Yes, we're going to start by breakfast, the most important of all.
That's right. Best meal of the day.
Let me warm up my pan. I'm getting excited here.
Okay. So what are we making for
I'm
breakfast?
I'm making a potato and chorizo hash.
Okay.
You're going to love that recipe. I'm going to bring a little bit of the Southwestern cuisine right into your plate.
Oh, I like
that.
You brought that Southwestern cuisine to beat Bobby Flay.
That's right.
And you beat him.
Yes,
that's right. So it must be good. You must know that.
You know what? He never called me since then.
I wonder why.
Well, he never called me before either.
Nah.
Well, anyways, here is your potatoes.
Potatoes. You want
and
me to smash those?
I have little potatoes. So those are fingerling potatoes.
Okay.
I've boiled them earlier. And what I want you to do is just take a fork and smash them, just like this.
Okay.
So we have little chunks. I still want to recognize them at the end.
Okay.
And I want to create that nice ash.
Okay.
Will do. As you do that, I'm going to put a little bit of my deliciousness right into the pan.
Okay, your chorizo.
A little bit of oil, just to keep the chorizo going.
So that, what kind of oil are you using?
I'm using your favorite oil, because I have to deal with you. So
that's right.
Here it is, your avocado oil.
Avocado oil. I love avocado oil, because it's similar to canola oil in that it can be cooked at a high heat without it ruining the oil. Where if you cook with different oils, like extra virgin olive oil, what else? Let's see, coconut oil, even butter will burn sometimes.
Yeah.
Those are made for a little bit lower heat. So avocado oil is my go-to because you can use it for just about everything and it's still a really healthy fat.
Nice. You could stop right here on the potato.
That's enough.
I have a little bit of corn over here.
All right.
Grab it from your table.
You're stealing from my side,
I'm
the vegetable side.
Stealing a little bit of corn.
Okay.
A little bit on the Southwestern style there.
Yep.
A little bit of red bell.
I like it. A little bit of crunch in there. You're getting some fiber, which is good with the vegetables.
And let me tell you something. It's nothing that smells like chorizo. Because if you want to bring
flavor.
The family in the table in the morning and you don't want to scream at them, honey, coming is breakfast.
Yep.
Then the best is to put a little bit of chorizo and let them just
chorizo
follow
breaking,
the smell.
Right? Draws everyone out of the beds.
You can put your potatoes right there.
Put them right in there.
Yeah.
Okay.
And put a little bit of salt, because potatoes, big salt heater.
They do. They need a lot of salt so they don't taste bland.
Crank a little bit.
So
of
if I were to
pepper.
Make this like a little bit healthier, I would maybe a bit less chorizo. I'd still do the avocado oil. You'd like it. Trust me.
Okay.
I might switch it out for like some sweet potatoes. I think that'd be good.
Sweet potatoes.
Bring a little bit of sweetness, but you still get that starchiness from the potatoes.
I'm gonna put a little bit of cilantro.
Okay.
Same thing, so you gotta roll a little bit. Cilantro!
Cilantro, did you know, is actually very good for your liver.
Oh.
Helps detox.
That's
so
good. That might help with the chorizo.
It'll help with like, if you like your wine, you French people, you like your wine.
Okay.
It's gonna help you detox your liver.
So as long as I have a little bit of cilantro next to my wine,
you
I should
drink.
Do just fine.
That's right.
Okay.
It smells good.
Hey. It looks really, really nice.
It does.
It's getting a little crusty over here. I have a nice presentation plate.
Beautiful. And we also have our egg that I'm going to bring from my side.
Nice.
Because eggs actually are a really healthy item. And, you know, a few years ago, people were saying that they would affect your cholesterol. They had this bad fat, so throw out the yolk and eat the egg whites. But actually, the science is changing, and so you really can.
Thank you,
the egg
science.
Yolk, I know, thank you
comes
so much.
Back to
because
the, yolk the egg yolk was the,
is
best,
the best part,
part
yes. Right? So now I would definitely say eat that egg yolk. Actually, if it's a little bit runny like this, that's actually going to be better. The heat hasn't destroyed those really good fat elements. So this is how I like it.
All right. I think we're going to start with a little bit of avocado crema that you prepared for us earlier too.
Yep, so I made an avocado crema. And so all I did for this was I put two avocados into a food processor with some lime juice and then just pureed it till it's nice and smooth.
That's going to go very well with the Southwestern team.
Yep. So in a nice color too.
And presented it, you do that. That's very
Thank
nice.
You
did very good.
The chef
I'm
side coming out.
A little bit of, we're going to make
ring.
It fancy today. Wanna add the ring, yeah?
So this is making me happy. We got some avocado on our plate. That's some healthy fat. We got our egg. We got a little bit of vegetables in there.
Yeah,
I'm
we
happy.
Have some vegetables in there. Potato grows in the dirt.
The only problem with potatoes is that typically, and the vegetables that are more white, like potatoes, not vegetables. Cauliflower is a white vegetable, but very good for you. But like potatoes, bread, those things are not going to be as healthy for us as some of the more colorful vegetables.
Okay, but you need to have it because
it's a balance. Of the soul, it's a balance.
You know? What's going to happen if you eat three cucumber next time you're going next to a restaurant? It's going to smell good, and that's it. That's the end of your diet.
I don't know. I like my sweet potatoes. They're good.
Okay, okay.
That looks very nice.
So,
honors of the egg? Oh, that looks beautiful. Those colors. I love it.
Yes. So the eggs, you use a little eggs holder here, the same ring size that I have, or very similar. That's going to help a lot to create that beautiful effect here.
Mm-hmm. Let's get it on there.
Here is my eggs.
So presentation, you could do it, you know, you could just put it on the plate, but this looks so beautiful.
It looks pretty, huh, isn't it? I'm going to add a little bit of salt right on the top. And a little bit of my favorite hot sauce.
Hot sauce kicks the flavor up.
Oh yeah, just like
That's very nice.
It looks very beautiful and contemporary and delicious.
Yep.
I mean, it looks like it comes straight from my side.
It does. Beautiful. So should we cut that egg yolk open?
Oh yeah, we should.
Are you going to do the honors?
I'm going to do the honors.
All right.
And, I'm going to cut that. Oh yeah.
Oh, that looks so good. That's the best part.
Here is for you, a fork.
Okay. Give it a try.
Let's dig in.
I'm going to try some of the crema. Mmm.
Makes me want
to spice to it.
Do my little happy dance over here.
Mm, woo! That's delicious,
This
though.
Is really good.
Mmm. That is satisfying.
That's on breakfast if you have some guests coming over.
They're going to love you. You're going to be the hostess with the mostest. Or the host with the most.
Well, that will be it for this segment. So when we come back, I'm going to cook a halibut, black crusted, and I know you're going to make a ratatouille with that.
I am going to make a ratatouille. So I'm going to be deconstructed, so a little bit different than the classic
So I got to tell the French people to change channel it's going to be very, very different.
I know, but simpler. So don't go anywhere, guys.
We'll be right back. A new episode will be posted every Tuesday and Thursday, so don't forget to subscribe right below or visit us website at www.htcooking.tv.